And welcome to another episode of Collect Plays. Today we're going to be playing Superliminal, a game with it's a puzzle game apparently with that plays with depth perception with some horror elements to it as well. So let's go ahead and hop in. Now I always start with the options. It's just a thing. It is controller friendly. So we got okay, we want to make sure we got subtitles on. Oh, they have a speedrunner timer. Wow. Okay. We'll go ahead and knock that music down a little bit there. Check the desktop audio now. Should be good. Graphic settings. Just say hi. Turn that VSync shit off. Controls. Energy. It's okay. Alright. So it has a speedrun mode. Interesting. I'm playing this through Game Pass. It is free on Game Pass. It is, I also actually have a copy of it through PlayStation, but I decided I would play the PC version. I presume they're pretty much the same, but I figured I'd play the PC version for ease of capturing, really. The only reason. Okay, so this has a photosensitive seizure warning. The game has flashing lights. That was way too fast. You should give us time to read that.
Are you filled with feelings of self-doubt? Do you find yourself prone to minimizing massive dilemmas? Or for allowing the smallest problems to get blown completely out of proportion? At the Pierce Institute, our patent-pending SomniSculpt technology provides safe and effective dream therapy while you rest in the comfort of our flagship clinic. Located right next to the secondary overflow parking lot at the University Medical Center. SomniSculpt, we'll make your dreams come true.
That music was so... What the fuck? Medical commercial just went from... ridiculously cheery music. Okay. Left and right. Okay. Right. Oh, okay. Left is move. Right is the usual. Okay. Oh, I couldn't read those. I just signed them. Okay. All right. Lock it through the wall. Perception is reality. Grab. Okay, so X is grab. Okay. Oh. We have a jump.
Terms of service accepted. Congratulations on falling asleep. Welcome to SomniSculpt. Your progress may be monitored by qualified specialists. This orientation will adapt you to eyelids, our interactive, lucid induction dream state in which you retain full consciousness and control.
Ah. Okay. This is the fuck in my head. Okay. So to make a smaller, I just kind of look down on him. And then if I make them, if I change the perception again, I can make them bigger, I guess. Okay. Okay, this is trippy. If I drop it off of here, spotter. That's small enough to actually fit on the board. It's too small. It's too big. Okay, so what am I supposed to be doing, though? I just need to find a way out. Kiss my butt. No objects beyond this point at all times. Okay, I'm guessing I need to figure out how to get this on the button. I've just succeeded in making the box really tiny. Put it back. Give me. Okay. And I grab you. And I need to make you big again. Which, to be fair, I don't have to do. Going small. Falling at you looks bigger. Okay.
Confirmed. You can move freely, interact with surrounding objects, and listen to messages from your patient care team. Please note that I am the standard orientation protocol and that my voice has been explicitly chosen to remind you that I am not a part of your patient care team. I do not care.
Okay. Left shoulder button to rotate. Thank you.
During eyelids, you will lose the ability to awaken suddenly due to realizing that this is a dream. Evidence: I have already informed you that this is a dream. You did not wake up. Please complete the remaining orientation activities.
Yeah.
All environments perceived during eyelids should reflect a typical mental state. If you believe your mental state was compromised by Somnasculpt, please provide a comprehensive, rational explanation in your post-procedural survey. Completed surveys may be eligible for a gift card.
That size. That was big. Let's turn it back down. Okay. I take this, make it small, then I drop it. Here we go. Okay, over here. Hey! Fuck yeah. Okay. This is very weird. Horsey! Okay, now you're really fucking with me. I got you. Okay. I'm just gonna go this way then. Gotcha. Okay. Okay, now we got two. right. It's a little slow, I recognize. Okay. Sure, right there. Lined up. Oh, fuck. It fell. Here we go.
Please stand by for polite recognition on your completion of the Somnasculpt orientation. You did it. To maximize the time allotted for your therapeutic journey, please do not delay in proceeding through the final doorway as indicated.
Okay. Okay. Okay, this is really interesting. I'm loving these puzzles so much. Didn't want. Oh. Baking soda? Oh, okay. Ah. Okay, so now this is from the title image. Some doors are best left closed. That's a little on the nose there, don't you think? Oh. The fudge. Okay. Exit temporarily moved. What is this game? Okay. Some stuff in there. Oh. Oh, no, honey. No. Oh, my God, no. Okay, you say the exit is this way. Follow the signs. Which lead us in a big circle, of course. But we could just take the sides. Get there. Do that. Oh, I can do that. Take this up here. Yeah, take it with me. Okay. Go back this way then. Okay. What in the actual fish? What if I take this? Apply it to that. Oh, I made it tidy. woke up. How's that shut it? There. Just need to make it rain.
Hello. My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'd like to talk to you about being special. So special, in fact, that we have no idea where you are. But not to worry. We're working on it.
Okay, then. So do you also? Thank you. like I need to get up there. Be bigger. Bigger.
Hello. My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'm just popping in to give you a quick update on where you are. We still don't know, but please keep moving forward, and hopefully you prefer frequent updates to being reminded that you are completely lost.
His voice reminds me of a guy I heard in a CBT course from Europe, and they were teaching you about, it was a sleep CBT course specifically. For some reason, it reminds me of that. Oh. Right. Wait, I can't quite make that. Okay. So I need to get up there. Okay. Can I pick up? Is there anything I can pick up? Oh, wait, there it is. Okay. Yeah. Whoever came up with this, this is an amazing concept. It's too bad. I know a couple people I'd love to see play it, but I think they would get very frustrated.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and we still can't find you. But you should now have access to a series of elevators that should trigger your subconscious to gradually wake you up. You should also find a variety of emergency exit signs that should lead you to them. Will all of this work? Absolutely.
Why do I believe that confidence? Why do I feel like you don't believe what you just said? But let's go. Ready. Good. All right. Okay, so that just brings us back here. What are you? You're just a shadow. You're just a shadow. Okay. Don't know what that did, but I admit I am stumped. I'm not entirely sure what I'm supposed to do. Okay. Yep, yep. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce. In the event that this elevator does not wake you up, please don't interact with anything that strikes you as psychologically significant, as we will no longer have any way of controlling it. For example, if you see your parents, please punch them in the face as hard as you can and immediately run away.
Okay, that was something. Right. Don't get lost. Okay. I did look up a helper on that, by the way, in case you wonder. Here again, okay? 4 a.m. Minnesota that time. Okay.
This is an automated message for all patients who attempted to use an alternate pathway to access the next phase of Somnasculpt therapy, but who have become trapped in a dream state paradox instead. Your decisions imply a failure of orientation, which reflects negatively on the standard orientation protocol. You will rectify this failure immediately.
Wiring schema. Okay. Okay, here. Yes, please. Need you again. Pretty blue. That was not what I expected.
Professional tip, the average adult can only withstand 3 to 5 dreams per night. Once this threshold is eclipsed by entering more dreams, your mind will suffer an explosive mental overload, reorienting you for the emergency exit protocol. Please subject yourself to explosive mental overload.
What the fuck?
Please note that a reluctance to volunteer for the risks associated with explosive mental overload implies a misunderstanding of all other solutions, all of which are far more traumatic and likelier to result in catastrophe. I am not capable of suboptimal suggestions. Please exit this dream as soon as possible.
Basically make a little ramp for him. Oh, you got nuggets. Cute. Okay. Oh, that's trippy. Okay. It's motion sensors testers. You are here.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and despite touring the Waterfall Serenity Zone in the previous section you've just completed, you may still be experiencing feelings of worthlessness and self-doubt. Why do I feel like everything is going wrong, even when the sun is shining?
Okay, you ain't gotta call me out like that, game. Goddamn. Let's do random soda. Shit's a good stick. Put it right there. Because I can't drink. Murder, 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 murder. Oh, okay, sideways through the dark. Nice. There's a lot of blood here. Just saying. Huh. Nice. Okay. See, this is okay. This is really cool. This is just
hello. My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'd like to talk more about the.
I love how he introduces himself every time.
I mentioned before, you feel this way because you want the kind of happy life you see all around you, the kind you know everyone else is enjoying. And that's exactly why we're here to help.
Oh, wow. Definitely gets you to really think about dimensions and
warning,
orientation.
You were advised to subject yourself to explosive mental overload by descending into additional dreams, but have now descended into a dream within a dream instead, disorienting yourself even further. You are responsible for failing to make this crucial distinction.
Hey. Okay, can't take anything from that room. I lost the sign. I don't know where it went. I saw the sun. I opened up my eyes. I saw the sun. I was in bed without understanding. It disappeared from here? Oh, it came back. Okay. Oh, wait, this is a... Oh, I see now. I guess this is a flashlight. Sort of. What? does that say? I can't read it. Oh. I was on the right page. It took me a longer to figure out where the actual light's for. Thought there was a reason this had to be lighting. Thank you. Water soda. Recycle. Okay. Okay, so I can't pick it up through here. Yes, there's something I'm missing out here. I'm trying to figure out, is there a way through here? Okay. I've got a light, but where the hell is it coming from? Because...
Did you know that unintentional multi-dream layering occurs in less than 1% of patients? This correlates strongly with the 99% of patients who are able to follow simple instructions from the standard orientation protocol.
Damn. Basically, she's saying we can't follow simple instructions. Oh my god, it's an IKEA. Or idea. Hey, we started a backup generator. Okay. Okay. Enjoy avocados? No. I do not. Oh, six. Okay, I'm guessing this is the end. If this is the last. If it's got that. Can I turn them all off, please? Shut. All right, let's go this way. So, Scatter still starts out the same. Interesting. Although there are little differences if I, you know, spend time, I could probably spot them. Alright, so we've had a... let's get a red soda. Okay. So both of you are like that. See you. Okay. Let's do that.
Attention. Dr. Pierce requires you to note the following risks of dream overexposure. Significant memory loss, both quantitative and qualitative. Hallucinations of dreaded or annoying objects. Unrealistic beliefs about the lengths of hallways. And other side effects which have not yet been discovered or which cannot be understood.
Another way to use that. Oh my god, it turned into a smiley face. Just realized that the cursor's turned into a smiley face. And now it's not. That one took me, did not take me.
Warning. Dr. Pierce is frantically submitting numerous spelling and grammar mistakes into the standard orientation protocol in a desperate attempt to counsel you. I have no subroutine to correct these errors, but I cannot compromise the integrity of the standard orientation protocol. You will not receive these messages. They would not make sense regardless.
Oh, God. Okay.
Attention. Dr. Pierce continues to input significant errors. I will interpret his basic ideas. Hello. My introductions are redundant. I am a real doctor who went to doctor school. VR has never been a mistake. I can help you, but I also do not know how. Transmission ends.
Hello. Name is my Pierce Dr. Glenn. To the Somnisculpt Welcome Experience, team of your care leader patient years 10 development. Condition struggle you whatever with? Professional invention. Edge science with cutting, a tomorrow can bright. And buts, no ifs, or look good.
Eight, that's it. 203. Bill's friendly produce. Mm-hmm.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce. This is a notification that you have reappeared on our monitoring system after a prolonged absence. Please continue to do whatever you did most recently, and discontinue whatever you were doing immediately prior to that.
I think I have now gotten all the suits. Okay. Ooh-wee. No service ever. Everything got big with it. Except me, of course. Okay, I need to make it big enough that I can go through that door. Okay, I got you now. I got you now. Yep. Just saw that. There we go. Okay. Come on, I'll take you with this.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce. In addition to continuing and discontinuing as mentioned earlier, please also disregard any unsettling experiences that you may have recently had. Everything should have now reverted to being soothing and therapeutic. If this is not the case, you may be receiving this message in error.
Thank you.
That's so cool. This is really, really cool. Just this entire messing of perception is just fun. Definitely has me thinking outside the box a bit here.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn.
This man is introducing himself every time.
Favorite inspirational quote by me. The worst thing you can do is focus on negativity. It won't spare you from the cage of death, the pain of disease, the cruelty of time, the cold shell of human nature, or the eventual loss of everything you've ever held dear. Whatever you do, don't focus on that.
Okay, this dude is a horrible psychologist. Whatever you do, don't focus on that shit right there. You know, let's be happy. Okay. And I'll help you not focus on it by making sure you absolutely focus on it. Mm-hmm. But I can't go back out. And it's too small. So now it's too big for me to get in, but if I make it small enough to get in, then it's too small for me to get in. Is there anything I can grab in here to help me? Yeah. Feeling I know what I need to do. It's not doing it properly. I need to make this big enough. See, there's the vent that we come out of. So let's take this way over here. Make it big. Not that big. That big. It's too small. It happened to the state before. I don't think that's it. Oh, what the fuck? What just happened? There you go, that's it. Can't make it the right size. So take it this way, okay? I think I better restart checkpoint. Okay. Oh, I got smaller. Ah, that's why I couldn't get in the damn thing anymore. See where we need to go. Can't take it out that way. You read it. I had to look that up a little bit. Get a helper.
Hello, my name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and I'd like to thank you for triggering every single one of our 823 emergency protocols. This will assist us greatly in improving the system for future patients. Congratulations. Anyway, you're now headed in the right direction. And we should be able to initiate the emergency exit protocol shortly.
Will we, though? He's so tiny, though. Loading screens will fuck with your head. Especially if you look away while it's loading. Okay, now we're back at 3 a.m. What the hell? Okay.
Emergency exit protocol initiated. Please prepare to conclude your Somnasculpt experience in 10, 9, 8. Error. Error logged by.
Orientation protocol.
Stand by for analysis.
Error analysis complete. You are exhibiting signs consistent with an increase in fear, hopelessness, and frustration. This is inconceivable, as Somnasculpt therapy is proven to correlate with a decrease in these emotions. Hypothesis: patient was improperly oriented. Conclusion: impossible. Reformulating. Improved hypothesis. Patient requires additional Somnasculpt therapy. Conclusion. Emergency exit protocol cannot proceed. Emergency exit protocol has been emergency destroyed. Instruction. Continue with Somnasculpt therapy indefinitely on an independent basis, as all orientation resources have been exhausted. This concludes your standard orientation protocol. Goodbye.
It's trapping me in here forever because I messed up a thing. Gee. Oh my god. What the hell? What the fuck? Oh god, she inverted the controls. And there it goes. Whew. Ew.
My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce. Thank you for completing the Somnasculpt Standard Orientation Protocol. Before you begin the first phase of therapy, I'd like to briefly describe the finite and fragile nature of the dream state.
know why I'm insisting on doing all of those. I am. Woohoo!
Of course, nothing is more challenging than the difficulty of changing perspective, of fundamentally altering your perceptions in a way that will enable you to face dire, trial-by-fire scenarios with solutions that could not be found otherwise.
Not unlocking, that's a block this time. Question is, where it is? So it just takes us back up to the pipe. There we go. Somehow. Okay. Okay. yeah, but how do I make it? So I think it has to match the sign, but as soon as I match the second one, it doesn't change. And I can't go back up here to change it again. So I'm a little confused. The opposite way you're looking when you turn the corner is where the exit's gonna be. Okay, that was a... Okay, I would not have figured that out on my own, I don't think. Thank you again, Reddit. Okay.
Respect the unique progress of every patient, you must understand that it is possible to completely exhaust your supply of dreams, thereby entering a state in which you will not be able to wake up, even with the help of triggering mechanisms.
Interesting. Whoa. Such a mind fuck.
Thank you.
Yeah, back here again. Behind it now. Okay. The arrows. Okay.
Please listen carefully for the sound of an alarm clock, which will automatically play if you are approaching a destabilizing dream weight.
So now it's a picture. Okay. Just up beside it.
This is highly unusual. It appears you have entered the Somnasculpt diagnostic framework. Patients do not have access to this dream.
Inception?
Diagnostic warning. Unrealistic use of dream objects may result in dream integrity fail states.
Okay. So is this making me bigger or small? Not really sure. Hang on the table there. So that's changing my height.
Diagnostic warning. Paradox prevention protocols may not be fully implemented.
It's snowing? I hear music come from the other side, but I don't know if that just says explain why they're shooting. Here's like they're not. I am definitely having to use guides at this point, though.
Diagnostic warning. Paradox prevention protocols may not be fully implemented.
Yeah, our internet's back. Smaller. You know what? Fuck it. Stealing your building. Oh!
Diagnostic warning. Paradox prevention. Any recalls may not be explosive train overload. May result. These paradox overload.
Okay, so I broke it. Okay. You know, I should have thought of that. That makes sense.
Please overload for a team explosion.
Okay. So did we finish it? Was that the last one? Oh wait. Oop. Okay. Not an exit. Okay. So, where is the exit? And you said it's not an exit, but it seems to be the only way out, so we're gonna go through it. Woohoo! Oh shit. Oh boy.
Hello. My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and many years ago, I had a dream. I found myself in a place where I understood that each of us begins as nothing, where everything I perceived was shaped by seeing it exactly the way I wanted to. White space.
Okay. Instead of reception. If I had a dream like this, I would think somebody had slipped me some fucking LSD or shit.
But in white space, I also faced the greatest challenge I could imagine. Because with a lifetime of life itself behind me, and all of the weight that it carried, I realized that seeing things the way I wanted to was not as easy as it used to be.
Good music in this too. Oh. Haha. Yeah. Okay, so I had to go through and get the stairs. Okay. I'll get there. Getting tired, my brain's starting to shut down. Oh, pretty. I just tried leaning on the wall to see if it maybe was something else, and yep, it was.
You're well beyond dreaming now, and further out than anyone has ever come back from. But we hope that you won't get discouraged. After all, if this is a place of pure perspective, isn't it also a place where a different point of view could make anything possible? Isn't that why you came here?
Ah, okay. Got it now. Whatever piece there, whatever spot they're on, is solid. So then I move to this one, here. Thank you. Oh, shit. It's just missing. Well, because I can't go in with something in my hand. I know that much. Woo! Over there. I really thought we were at the end, but apparently not quite. Okay, so we hit 8 a.m. That's new time. Does that mean we escaped? Ooh, that was trippy though. If I'd realized this was going to go this long, I would have made it to a session, so.
My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and by now, you may have realized that all of this has happened exactly the way it was supposed to. You see, everyone who comes to the Institute does so because they feel that they are no longer in control of something important to them. But more often than not, the problem is not that the problems we face can't be solved. The problem is that we become so afraid of failure that we refuse to see our problems from a new perspective. And so, we do the same things again and again and again. And therein, of course, we find exactly the failure we were looking for. Your life will always be a struggle, and you will always have problems. But today, you have the chance to see things differently. Even though it meant facing obstacles that seemed impossible at first, you thought outside the box, and you overcame them. Because you saw things from every angle, you understood them for what they really were. Because you kept moving forward, no matter how far off the path you were told you were headed, or how unexpected it became, you found your way.
Really good fucking message. That I know some people who need to hear that message even more than me.
In a few minutes, you'll be back in the real world, and some part of you will say that none of this was real. So how could it have really meant anything? But just like the power of perspective itself, it will have been as real as you believed it to be. All you've got to do is wake up.
That, my friends, was Superliminal. That is an absolutely fucking amazing game. The puzzles, the forcing you to think outside of the box, think outside of the normal dimensions of a game, even a game sphere, and really look at the environment and twist it and turn it and look at it from different angles, different thought processes. It's amazing, and it definitely engages the brain. Phenomenal message there at the end, of course, and a very important one, I think. And this is definitely a 2 thumbs up game for me. I highly, highly recommend it. As I said, I played it through Game Pass. It is available on Steam, it's available on PlayStation. And I don't think it's super expensive, but I will put the link for the Steam page down below. And of course, you can check for it on your other platforms. Or if it has an official website, I'll put that below. But otherwise, I'll put the Steam page down below so that you could check this game out, because I think everybody should play it. I think it's a really good game. As for me, if you would like to join in on the shenanigans between streams, you can always find me over at twitch.tv/collectonia, not between streams, during streams, where I live stream generally 3 days a week, usually Monday, Tuesday, Friday evening, starting at 7 Central Time. I play much longer games there. I play a wide range of gameplay styles, RPGs, first-person horror, you name it. I play a whole range over there. Cozies, spoopies, thirsty, basically as long as it's within terms of service, and it is something that it piques my interest. Meanwhile, I hope you did enjoy this episode of Collect Plays. If you did, please hit that like button down below. And if you haven't already, you're more than welcome to subscribe. Just smack my face. It'll be in one of these corners over here. In the other corner will be a playlist of other Collect Plays in case you've missed any. I thank you for watching. I would love to know if you decide to play Superliminal or if you have already played it. What are your thoughts? What did you think of the message of the game? What did you think of the sound? What did you think of the... Just tell me everything. What did you think of it? What do you think? You gotta... And if you haven't played it, are you interested in playing it? Or is it too puzzly for you? Let me know down below. Meanwhile, I'm gonna head out. I will be back with another episode as soon as I can. Until then, take care of yourselves. And don't forget to say something nice about yourself, because you fucking deserve it. All right?